Yep, so that happened. After waiting for years on Apple to make a USB-C iPhone, I decided I had enough. I'll just make one myself. This video is to document how I finally made this iPhone, the first one of its kind. If you're curious about technology, you should definitely stick around because I'll be walking you through the whole thought process of the project, with its up and downs and really going into the details. So let's get started. As with any project, you need to set clear and realistic goals for yourself. Mine were the following. The minimum requirements are that it charges and that data works whenever I plug in the cable. So reversibility needs to work. Then you need to write down a rough plan to follow. Mine looked a little bit like this. Once that's done, you go through the steps methodically and do whatever is needed to achieve them. Let's start with the first goal, which was building a proof of concept. This is what I did in my part 1 video. If you haven't watched it, don't worry, I will quickly summarize it here. There exist Lightning to USB-C cables, right? To connect your iPhone to your MacBook? Well, what if I could take that cable, transform the USB-C male end into a female one with a custom board, and then miniaturize all this to put it inside the iPhone? Let's test the hypothesis. First, I went on classified ads and bought the cheapest iPhone I could get my hands on, that was still half decent at that time. It was an iPhone X. I wanted to see if it's possible to make a Type-C female to female board, but I found no information about this online. Just that I shouldn't do this. Great. Then I went on Google Images and finally saw something that looked like what I had in mind, so I ordered it. It arrived, I tried it out, and it didn't work. Damn, it's gonna be harder than I thought. I took some time to think. I tried again, but I plugged it the other way around. You never know, and it worked. Okay, that's a start, but I need to dig deeper inside the cable and find out how it really works. Before I continue, you need to be familiar with what a continuity test is. Let's say I have a conductive point A at point B. I want to know if they are directly linked with a cable or trace on a PCB. I take my multimeter, put it in continuity mode, and then touch both points with my probes. A small current is sent and the resistance is measured. If it is very low, then the multimeter emits a tone to indicate continuity. On the other hand, if there is something in between, like a resistor for example, the multimeter won't emit a tone. So now we are ready to dig in the cable. I simply cut it in half to expose the wires that are inside. From experience, I recognize the color of the wires and I can already have a pretty good idea of what they do. Then I bring my USB-C female breakout board and run a continuity test between the first wire and every pin of the USB-C connector. This allows me to know where it connects to. Then I switch to the next wire and do the same thing again. This allowed me to have the knowledge to remove two connectors from my circuit and make it simpler. Remember how I said it only worked one way? Well, I had to go through the USB Type-C specification and I found this table which told me I could easily fix it by adding a 5.1 kOhm resistor on pin B5. This method limits the charging speed when plugged in one of the two ways, but I chose it anyway because I wanted to get a prototype out as soon as possible. Now that we have the USB side figured out, let's have a closer look at the Lightning side. I will make this diagram a little bit more complicated. Now it shows the internal flex cable of the Lightning female port. You can actually keep it plugged in, but bend it backwards so that it is outside of the phone. It makes things much easier when troubleshooting. What I want is to remove this connector. I always start with the easy part to give myself confidence. Now that this connector is removed, let's focus on a last piece to fully understand what is happening here. First, I need to crack open that plastic around the Lightning male connector to see what is inside. Trust me, it is not an easy task, and this is by design. The connector that is inside the cable sold by Apple is called C91, and it is built like a tank. Not very convenient if I need to open it up multiple times. So I looked around and I ordered all the third-party MFI cables I could find to see if one was easier to open than Apple's. The board they have inside is called C94 and it is sold by Apple to third-party manufacturers. You might notice that there is still the lightning connector made out of metal and plastic underneath. I wanted to find a way to remove this part to see what it was hiding. So I tried many ways to do that, with chemicals, by grinding it, but in the end, the best way was by heating the metallic part with a soldering iron and then pulling out when the plastic underneath starts to melt. On the right, you can see the result I got. To give a quick overview of the situation, we have our flex PCB where we removed the lightning connector. We have a bare C94 PCB which we can solder wire straight to the pads on the flex cable, and we have our USB-C female board where we can also solder wires too. This is how far I got in my proof of concept video. Now we want to reverse engineer the C94 connector because I don't see how I can fit it inside the iPhone otherwise. The board doesn't look like it has many components, so it shouldn't be too complicated. Well, actually the board has a first layer of glue on top of the components which is not too hard to remove, but then most of the components are covered by a composite material called underfill. It is used so that there will be less strain on the chips, but another consequence is that it is much harder for me or anyone else to remove them safely. While doing some research on a C94 connector, I stumbled across some articles mentioning that it had been hacked by someone in China and that fake connectors were hitting the market. I decided to do some research and went on Taobao, the Chinese eBay. It was a gold mine. I ordered all the boards I could find. The thing is, they only ship to China. So what I did was to use an agent to ship my order to the agent's warehouse in mainland China. Then the agent shipped again that order from their warehouse to my place in Switzerland. The boards arrived and one of them caught my attention. It looked pretty damn close to the original, so that's the one I chose. I thought, screw it. I will reverse engineer the reverse engineers. It will make my life much easier because there is no underfill and I'll also be able to share the schematics without infringing any Apple intellectual property. Perfect. So how do I recreate the schematics of this fake C94 board? You can view a schematic as a map where there is houses with multiple doors and then roads that make connection in between those doors. Well, the first thing I need to do is to remove all the components, so all the houses. Then on our board, the components are gone, but the parts are still here. They are kind of like doorsteps. Remember the continuity test? Well, here it comes again. By trying every combination possible of the doorsteps, I can recreate a map of all the roads that link them together. Then, I carefully measure the values of the components I can measure, and I document everything. And here we go, I now have everything I need to recreate the schematic. There is a problem though, a schematic is not enough to recreate completely the circuit and manufacture it. To make plans for my own PCB, I still need the footprint of every component. You can view it as 2D dimensions of each house. For most components, it was easy as there are standardized components. But for the two main chips, where all the magic happens, I had to create my own footprints. To do this, I take a high resolution picture of the chip and precisely measure its outside dimensions. Then, I bring the picture into a computer-aided design software and I set the scale of my picture from my measurements. This allows me to measure smaller details such as the size and position of the pads, i.e. the doorsteps. I do this for both chips and now I finally have everything I need. So first I design it from the schematic I had prepared. I'm going to order a big rigid PCB first because it is much cheaper than a flexible one. This will allow me to check if the schematic is correct and works as intended. The PCB arrived, I prepared it by soldering to it the components I had stolen on a fake C94 board. And it worked. Sweet. Now we simplified our circuit even more and we fully understand it. We can make it any shape we want. Let's make it fit inside the iPhone. It didn't take me long to spot something very interesting. There is a small gap in between the battery and the Taptic engine. It runs through the whole width of the iPhone. And here is the trick that made it all possible. I thought, almost all printed circuits inside this iPhone are on the same horizontal plane. What if I made my circuit thin enough and placed it vertically in the iPhone, in that small gap? There is only one way to find out. I need to try it. Remember that I'm still using wires to connect my board. This needs to go. I created a footprint with the same trick I used for the chips. Then I needed to define what shape my board will have. And this needs to be very precise. I used calipers to measure dimensions inside the iPhone, and I also used a scan of the Lightning Flex cable to help me out. Then I printed the final outline on a piece of paper to double check that everything looked fine. I imported that outline into KiCad. It is now just a game to find a way to fit all the components into that thin slice. I ordered the board and it arrived. What a beauty. I noticed I made some small mistakes, but they are not critical. Then I transferred all the components to that new PCB and soldered it to the Lightning Flexible connector. Damn, it's starting to look like an official product. It's crazy. The hole at the bottom of the iPhone is not big enough to fit the USB-C plug. I need to enlarge it. A CNC was programmed to increase the dimensions of the hole to perfectly match what we need. There was two main obstacles to overcome. The first one was that the iPhone has a back glass that would almost certainly shatter when I tighten it with the CNC vise. The solution was to design custom 3D printed brackets that held the frame in place. The second difficulty was that you need to give an origin to the CNC for every axis so that it starts milling at the correct spot. This is not trivial with an iPhone that has rounded edges everywhere. I used the method where you slowly approach the drill and as soon as you hear a metallic sound, it means that the drill touched the phone and you set your axis coordinate to zero. It was good enough. There is one problem left. I need some mechanical support for the connector inside the iPhone. I figure the screen will push down on the connector, so it will be enough support in this direction, but I need support in the same direction as when I plug in a cable. To do this, I use a 3D printed part that I designed precisely so that it is held by the two adjacent screw holes. I assemble everything back. My custom connector goes under the Taptic engine, bends 90 degrees and has vertical electronics. And then it bends 90 degrees again to bring the USB-C connector to the correct spot. I close the iPhone, the project is done. This has been my biggest project so far. By judging from the support I received from you all, I am certain that it is not the last. I am super motivated to tackle other similar projects, and if you want to be updated on them, please consider subscribing. You can also leave a comment if you have suggestions for my next project. So what's next? Well, I'm happy to announce that the whole project is now open source. The link to the GitHub repo is down in the description for those playing along at home. If you would like to port it to another iPhone model, have fun, and then please make a pull request so that everyone can benefit from it. If you want to know what I'm going to do with this particular iPhone, check out my other videos. That's it for today. Peace.